beauties, how we doing? How we feeling? If you're here for the very first time, hello, my name is Sheila and welcome to Vlogmas 2020. I am having some Diet Mountain Dew in my All is Calm, All is Bright Christmas mug, and I am about to attempt to do my nails. I have all of my stuff spread out here on my desk. I'll give you a shot of that here in a moment. And I'm gonna just talk to you for just a little bit about my nail care routine. It's been the same, so you probably have seen a version of this video at some point or another, but I may kind of like give you some new pointers or different things that I've noticed over the last few times that I've done my nails. So let's set this down. And yeah, so I am going to share, first of all, let me show you. This is what my table looks like. I'm using my desk, so I wanted to make sure I had something on here to keep my desk from getting any type of nail polish remover or the polish or any of that stuff on it, because we all know once that happens, your desk will be ruined or your table or whatever. So always, 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 beauties, put something down and make sure you stay within that little specified area. So let's talk about what you see here real quick. Like, so this little bag is a bag that I keep. I call it my handy bag. I think I got it at the dollar store, if I'm not mistaken. And I keep pretty much everything that I need to do my nails on the norm in this bag. I keep cuticle oil. I keep this one's cuticle oil. And then this one is like a cuticle remover. And then I have different versions of like different type of bases for my nail polish, which we won't get into all of those. But then I have things like clippers, and I have things like the cuticle like pusher. I don't know what the proper name for this is, but you use it to push your cuticles back. I have the wooden one as well as the spongy one. And then of course I always have loads and loads and loads of cotton balls in there. And for any of you living in the San Antonio area or anywhere where you have an HEB, I think there's a few places outside of San Antonio now that has HEBs. The HEB jumbo ones are the best. Like, they're 99 cents and I love them. You go to Walmart and either Walmart brand is even more expensive. So, and I also have a file. I have both types of files here. And this is something, I purchased this at the dollar store a while back as well, I believe. Oh wait, no. Actually, I think this came from Walmart maybe. I don't remember. But anyway, it has its own little pusher which allows you to use your cotton ball and you can kind of push on this and get as much nail polish remover as you so desire on your cotton ball in order to be able to take off your nail polish. I love this because I don't have to have the whole big bottle. It's perfect for traveling because whenever I travel, I just take this whole bag and I drop it over in my backpack, which you all know I have a traveling backpack. These two things have been a permanent part of my nail care routine for a while now. And it's one of those things where if it's not broken, don't fix it. So I have loved this. It has generally, like, when you've used something for a while, your body kind of adapts to it and then it no longer has the effect. But this I've been using for a very long time now, and I've shown this to you all before, and I know some of you have come on board with it. Y'all, this is still the happening for me. I'm still enjoying the out the door. This is the top coat that I'm using. I was using the Sachefi one. But you know, that one has all these different things about it and people saying different things about it. So I really went on the search to find a new one. And one of my subscribers did share with me that she liked this one. And so I have been using this one now nonstop. So yeah, this is now an all-time favorite. But yeah, these two things are a must-have for me all the time. And then today we're going to be applying this beautiful purple, which, oh, I didn't even think about it, but it kind of matches my little towel that I have down here. I am going to apply this purple because I saw this on a model, and well, I saw this on the Instagram. I don't know if it was the same exact purple, but it was OPI and it looked like the same purple. And I was like, hey, I have that color. And I almost got rid of this color when I was cleaning out my nail polishes. And then I told myself, put it on and see what you think about it. And y'all, I think I'm gonna like it. I haven't put it on yet, but yeah, we'll see. But generally, all of these things will go inside this bag as well, so that if in the week I need to touch up my nails, I have the color already ready and I don't have to go through my nail kit. I usually place this right over here next to my little sofa, out of sight so people can see it, but I have it handy whenever I need it. So I know that sounds really anal, but that is truly how I do my nails. So we're just gonna sit here. I usually do a base coat, which is this one. I put one coat of this on, and then I'll put on a coat of this, and then I'll wait a few minutes and put another coat of this, and then I'll put on my top coat. So we're going to sit here. I have a Christmas movie on TV from the Hallmark Channel. Yeah, so we're just gonna sit here and do our nails while I watch the Christmas movie from the Hallmark Channel. Y'all like my little wig? I'm loving this little wig. Like, I have not played with wigs as much as I thought that I would during this cancer time of my life, but I kept wanting to try this one. This is one that I've had, and I actually used to just really pretty much wear it for like costume type things at Halloween and stuff like that. I think I've worn it a couple of times for things like that, but it's just a synthetic wig. There's nothing to it at all. I have no idea where it came from. My stepdaughter actually gave it to me many, many years ago. And okay, I'm like, what is that? But yeah, so I decided today, since it's cold outside, I'm gonna wear my little leather hat and I'm going to wear this little synthetic wig. So yeah, I kind of like it. It's brown. I don't do brown, but I like it. I like it. So anyway, let's get started. We don't want this video to be 20 minutes long. So I am going to, and of course this part will probably be sped up with some Christmas music playing in the background because, you know, it's boring just to sit and watch me do my nails. But before we get into it, this is what my nails look like. You all know, if you don't know, I just said it, but I'll say it again. I am a cancer survivor. I'm in recovery right now. I just had breast surgery on the 20th. I'm doing great. I have both my boobs still, but yeah. So anyway, this is what chemo will do to your nails if you don't know. And so, but as you can see, it is growing out and I will have my beautiful nail base again soon. But I will say that this stuff has been instrumental in keeping my nails very thick and very strong. Throughout the whole course of chemo, this stuff held up. So if you're a person and you're going through chemo, this might be something that you might want to try to keep your nails nice and strong. Or if you're just a person who have brittle nails and you're like, what do I do? This stuff is the bomb. So anyway, yeah, I got to get back to my movie. I will chat with y'all a little bit later. Let's see. The best dreams. Beauties, that concludes my nail care routine for this video. Make sure you subscribe before you go if you haven't already, and I will see you all tomorrow. Bye.